Evening friends, today we are going to discuss chapter number 2, class 12, biology, reproduction in flowering plants. So first of all we have to discuss flower, development of flower and development of its reproductive organs. Means we are going to discuss the pre-fertilization events in case of flowering plants in angiosperms, we can say. So these are the two structure considered as reproductive organs. One is androecium, and second is gynoecium. Androecium considered as a male reproductive organ of the plant, where gynoecium considered as a female reproductive part of the plant. Androecium is consist by stamens. A single stamen is consist by these structures like this. This is the filament. These are the anther sac. And if the stamen is diathecous, or another structure is present that is called as connective. Diathecous means bilobed anther. In case of family Solanaceae, the best example, Datura, diathecous stamen is present. In case of family Malvaceae, the best example is Hibiscus rosa-sinensis, China rose, monothecous stamen is present. So if a typical stamen is consist by diathecous stamen, it has three structures, one is the anther sac, connective and filament. Now we will discuss about the structure of this anther sac. This anther sac is like this. If a diathecous stamen, this is the anther sac, okay, and this is the position of connective yahan par hoga, theek hai. This anther sac is also called as sporangium, microsporangium. A microsporangium is consist by will have two lobes and four corners. Each corner will have this. These are called as microsporangia. If we are going to discuss the structure of microsporangia, it is consist by these four layers. This is the first layer, this is the second layer, this is the third layer. There are two layers of third layer, okay, and so the outermost is epidermis, middle layer is, sorry, this is endothecium, and the innermost layer, next layer is called as middle layer, and another layer which present inside the middle layer is what? Tapetum, and inside the tapetum some very special structures are present. These are called as sporogenous tissues. Sporogenous tissues are consist by number of cells, and these cells are, each and every cell is called as microspore mother cell. Means the cell which is going to produce microspores, okay. So you have to consider on these two structures especially. There is no special function performed by epidermis, is just protective layer, endothecium, middle layer, there is no special function. But tapetum is the most important structure of microsporangia. Tapetum is the structure which provide nourishment to the sporogenous tissues, and finally it will provide whenever this sporogenous tissues, or we can say microspore mother cells, finally change into microspores and pollen grains. These pollen grains will be taken nutrient from this tapetum. So tapetum is the structure which provides nourishment to the developing pollen grains, finally we can say. Okay, so how this microspore mother cell, like this is the microspore mother cell, is divided by meiotic division, meiosis 1, so it is changed into these two cells, and meiosis 2, now finally it will form these four cells, tetrad structures are these, ऐसा दिखाई देगा आपको 1 2 3 4 एंड वन बिहाइंड दिस, एक इसके पीछे, एक पीछे जो आपको यहां से नहीं दिखाई दे रहा 3D स्ट्रक्चर में, तो दीज स्ट्रक्चर्स आर कॉल्ड एज ट्रायंगुलर माइक्रोस्पोर्स. ओके, माइक्रोस्पोर फाइनली दे बिकम्स राउंडेड हो जाते हैं इस तरीके से, राउंडेड स्ट्रक्चर, ईच एंड एवरी ट्राइंगुलर स्ट्रक्चर चेंज इन टू राउंडेड स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, and this particular cell wall, the cell wall of this triangular structure is considered as entine. This entine is consist by cellulose and pectin, and finally one more, this microspore will further surrounded by one more special structure that is called as axine. Isko kya kahenge, axine. And this axine is consist by a special type of chemical that is called as sporopollenin. What is the speciality of this sporopollenin? Sporopollenin is non-biodegradable chemical. It is non-biodegradable chemical which cannot degrade by or decompose by microorganisms. That is why the pollen grains preserved in this atmosphere till the thousands of years. ओके, यहां पर जो स्पोरोपोलेनिन है वो इस माइक्रोस्पोर को कभी भी डीकम्पोज नहीं होने देता है, डिग्रेडेट नहीं होने देता है, ठीक है, माइक्रोबियल एक्टिविटीज को प्रोटेक्ट करता है, इसलिए जो पोलन ग्रेन है ये कभी भी डीकम्पोज नहीं होगा, और हजारों साल तक एक बार जो पोलन ग्रेन बन गया, अगर उसने पोलिनेशन में पार्टिसिपेट नहीं किया तो वो पोलन ग्रेन हजारों साल तक प्रिजर्व पड़ा रहेगा. Many times this question was asked. Sporopollenin के बारे में कई बार पूछा गया है, tapetum के function के बारे में कई बार पूछा गया है, इसलिए ध्यान रखिएगा. So this is the structure we can say complete developed. It is pollen grain. But अभी इसका development और बाकी है. जब हम आगे चलेंगे तो इसमें एक और माइटोटिक डिवीजन होगा. कौन सा डिवीजन होगा? माइटोटिक डिवीजन होगा, लेकिन ये स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ माइटोटिक डिवीजन होता है जिसमें जो न्यूक्लियस का तो कंप्लीट डिवीजन होता है लेकिन साइटोप्लाज्म का कंप्लीट डिवीजन नहीं होता है. इसलिए यहां पर एक स्मॉल सेल बनेगी और दूसरी बड़ी सेल बनेगी. दिस इज द एंटाइन एंड दिस इज द एक्साइन. एक्साइन में एक पर्टिकुलर पार्ट और होगा जहां पर स्पोरोपोलेनिन का डिपोजिशन नहीं होगा. तो दिस पर्टिकुलर स्ट्रक्चर इज कॉल्ड एज जर्म पोर. इसको क्या बोलेंगे? जर्म पोर, ठीक है. दिस इज व्हाट एक्साइन, दिस इज एंटाइन. द बिगर सेल इज कॉल्ड एज वेजिटेटिव सेल एंड द न्यूक्लियस ऑफ दिस वेजिटेटिव सेल इज कॉल्ड एज वेजिटेटिव न्यूक्लियस. ओके, and the smaller cell is called generative cell and the nucleus is called as generative nucleus. This is the structure of a complete developed pollen grain. This